Welcome to Conversations with Leaders. My name is Miriam McLemore, and I'm an enterprise strategist with AWS. I am thrilled today to have the opportunity to speak with Bryson Koehler. Bryson is the CTO of Equifax. Bryson, welcome.
It's so great to be here. Good to see you.
Yeah, so good to see you. Hey, Bryson, could you give us a little bit of your background and your role at Equifax?
So I'm a geek at heart. I have loved technology since I was 8 years old and have, you know, really spent my career helping companies leverage technology to transform who they are, how they work, and achieve better outcomes. And my role at Equifax as the CTO is I lead our technology and product organizations and look after all of the things that we're doing across our landscape of technology and all of our products globally to help Equifax continue its journey forward.
Now, you joined Equifax, what, 2018?
I joined in 2018, so I've been here 3 years.
Great. So you joined it kind of, I'm an Atlanta native, kind of a tough time for Equifax. Could you tell us a little bit about that?
So I love hard problems.
Yeah.
You know, as good engineers do, the harder the problem, the more exciting. I joined shortly after Mark Begor, our CEO, joined and, you know, signed up to help reinvent the company and really bring back trust to our customers and to our consumers to make sure that, you know, people would entrust their most precious data with Equifax, because we are a data company and we are a decision and intelligence company. And so if we don't have trust in terms of how we collect data, how we store data, how there's the right permissible use on data, and how that governance trail follows data end to end, then we won't be able to continue to solve and make better decisions, you know, with our customers. And so that's why I joined, was to help use technology to put Equifax on that track.
Now, not all of our listeners may know the issue that Equifax experienced, that so many companies have experienced. Could you share?
So in the summer of 2017, Equifax experienced a data security breach by a state actor. And so it was a very sophisticated, you know, attack on the company that really helped galvanize the company around a transformation of itself, how it operated, how it thought about technology, but not just technology, the culture, the people, our products, you know, really the full end-to-end working of how Equifax operated.
Now, you do probably have choices though on, you know, you guys have gone aggressively toward cloud.
Yes.
But you could have just, you know, kind of holed up and invested internally.
So when I arrived, we had a stated course of patching to currency.
Right.
Just making sure we got our systems to the right level of maintenance. And, you know, my reflection working with Mark and the rest of the senior leadership team was that that was really missing an opportunity to set Equifax up for a sustainable future. You know, it's one thing to invest to get to where you need to be, but it's another thing to make sure you're setting the company up for sustainability. You know, the cloud really enables an evergreen mindset of always being current, and really changing the culture to embrace a destroy and deploy mindset so that you're always on the latest.
Yep.
And that really would set the company up, not for just getting good at a moment in time, but staying good. You know, we wanted to be a leader in security. And to do that, to be a leader in security, you have to be making sure that the engineering practices, the discipline that you put in place, the repeatability of your software engineering, the deployment, you have to bake that in. And you can't bolt it on to the end. And then further, the opportunity for us to really rethink our data, to really be able to bring our data together, to remove some of the constraints that a legacy mindset will hold. Being able to bring that data together, leveraging the infinite horizontal scalability that public cloud provides, gives us the ability now to bring our data together, leverage best of breed encryption capabilities, leverage the compute capabilities of cloud to really provide an end-to-end view of data governance, and solve problems that we couldn't solve in the old way. And that cloud native mindset was not a lift and shift. It was not a let's go take all of the silos of things we have and just move its hosting location from, you know, a legacy on-prem data center to cloud. It was really a mindset that said we really need to rethink who we are and rebuild. And we've done that. We have about two applications that we decommissioned for every one application we've rebuilt, which shows you that product rationalization mindset that we've been able to achieve as we go through this. So every time we rebuild an application, we're able to shut two down. That's led to being able to shut down 12 data centers so far, which really continues to help us on that journey of kind of getting rid of the old, not just moving it, but getting rid of it and rebuilding in a cloud native mindset.
Absolutely. Now your customers are probably in lots of different places as far as their adoption of technology. What are you guys doing to help your customers on this journey so they can leverage all the new products that you are able to deliver to them?
You know, so we are a highly regulated business. And as we started this journey, it took a lot of conversations around how we would be better off doing this migration into public cloud than we would be staying on-prem. Building that trust, and that was through a lot of very technical, detailed architectural conversations, a lot of, you know, show and tell, and then prove. And, you know, that turned from, I think, disbelief in some cases to invitations to come back to help. So it turned from, Bryson, we're not really sure, to, hey, could you and your team come back? Because we now believe we're behind on our journey and you guys are ahead. Could you help us? And that was really inspiring for the team because, you know, you went from kind of feeling like maybe we were behind to now we were being respected by our customers as leaders.
Well, and it's terrific as someone who spends her day talking to customers about the journey to cloud and how you accomplish that. I think having a leader and a case study like you built at Equifax is so important, particularly to financial services, but to so many companies.
So there's a lot of great companies that leverage the cloud, but I think Equifax is in a different league with the fact that we're a global company, we operate in 26 countries, and we're highly regulated. We're highly regulated by regulators in all of those countries, and that is a different technical challenge to solve. And I think as we have solved that with close to 90,000 customers migrating so far, and every day putting new workloads on and migrating those revenue streams over, giving us 12 data centers that we've shut down so far of our legacy estate, that builds confidence in the financial services industry and beyond that the cloud really is the place to solve their most difficult technical challenges.
So, you know, you're now kind of there. What can you do today for customers that was very challenging to do before? If you were gonna, you know, sell this into a customer and say, okay, now we can.
Yeah, so we've still got some final mile work to do, but we've seen record new product innovations and launches as a company. You know, we launched more new products last year, even with everything going on in the world, than at any point in Equifax's history. Ever. And I think that's fantastic. And I think that's a testament to the speed of innovation that the cloud enables. So instead of asking Equifax, hey, Equifax, what do you know about Bryson? I am getting lots of different answers.
Right.
I can now respond back with a complete 360 view. And so our teams in Australia, the teams here in the US, you know, have launched new innovative reports and scores and capabilities, whether those are through traditional delivery mechanisms or through APIs, that give that 360 view. That's really bringing a bunch of attributes about me together in the right use, at the right time, with the right governance, at the right speed that we couldn't do before. And now we're able to innovate. You know, we're doing 160-ish, maybe 165 production builds a day across Equifax. So if you think about that kind of CI/CD pipeline,
from
maybe one a week, maybe.
Right.
So one a week to 160 plus a day,
okay. Right.
Massive velocity improvements. And I think we're just getting started on that. And that helps us, as you know, to lower risk, and improve customer satisfaction and keep us safer. Because every time we deploy, being on the latest image, being on the latest build, leveraging the latest, right. That's all a part of building security in versus bolting it on. And so all of those things demonstrate things we weren't able to easily do before.
Now, that also was a massive technology change, but cultural change,
yeah.
Right? Because there were people that I'm sure that were used to getting a report a certain way or having something work a certain way. How did you go down the cultural transformation?
So I think that this is more of a people journey than it is a technology one. You know, with partners like Amazon, you know, we don't have to build or invent a lot of technology.
Right?
Like, we're not inventing a lot of technology. We're inventing ways to use the technology, inventing ways to leverage the capabilities. We're unique in how we have stitched things together, how we've thought about deploying that in a highly automated, secure way. That's all true. But it enabled us to turn our attention to the people side. You know, so we're a large technology and product organization, you know, FTEs and contractors around the world. You know, we were over 8,500 at the peak of our transformation. That's a lot of people to make sure that we're aligned on where we're going.
Yeah.
And so we built an engineering handbook, which was basically our, you know, Bible around what we believed, our philosophy around technology, our philosophy around the processes. And, you know, all of our people read it. We take a test on it. We make sure that we're living by it. We grade ourselves on how well teams are living by it. We've got over 750 cloud certified engineers now at Equifax, which is fantastic.
Yeah.
And we've refreshed, you know, a good portion of the team as well, bringing in new mindset where, you know, people who have done this before can help teach, you know, those who haven't. And, you know, as a leader, I always say I look for three things. One, I want you to love what you do. Yeah. Two, I want to set you up for success. And three, I want to make you more employable. And part of making you more employable was teaching you the skills. And the technology skills of cloud are not just the technical skills. It's the way of working.
I love that. Bryson, thank you so much for spending time with us today and your insights.
You bet. It was great to see you.
Great to see you.